Indeed it is. Now, Jamie, did you know that Italy has an affinity for jazz?
Now, why did you have to do a turn?
That's my jazz.
Is that your jazz?
Yeah.
Now, you see why I was a bit shady earlier on with the offbeat? You do this to yourself.
I'm just jealous of these hips. They don't lie. But let's do this one. Really, the top Italian cities on my to-visit list, of course, I didn't get the opportunity to do it before the lockdown, is Naples, or otherwise known as Napoli in Italian. And aside from being one of the oldest urban areas in the world with absolutely incredible architecture, like the city's cathedral, the Duomo di San Gennaro, which is Naples, and it's located near Mount Vesuvius, which is still an active volcano that destroyed nearby Roman town Pompeii. I mean, look at all the rich history and magic involved in this place.
You think I'm lying, but I've actually been there.
What?
So when I was on cruise ships.
You!
I know,
what?
Right?
Wow.
We were in Italy, we actually visited Napoli.
Okay.
And I actually had the pleasure of visiting the Pompeii ruins. So wow. Beautiful. It was just a huge culture shock, but absolutely stunning. It has to be on your go-to place. But also it's known for its culinary destination. It's famous for its spaghetti and, of course, the birthplace of pizza, pizzeria. Naples is also considered the Italian capital of coffee, with important coffee inventions like, get this, the flip coffee pot from which the espresso machine was invented. Now, considering this, it's no wonder that Nespresso pays tribute to the short, strong, and dark espressos this important coffee destination is known for with its Ispirazione Napoli. Okay?
You're selling this whole thing about Italy, and I think the only way I can really test it and make sure is if you make us a beautiful coffee.
So you can
course.
Either make it as an espresso or a ristretto. So
I like the ristretto. The fact that there's a good sort of intensity to this means that I don't have to have too much of it, and I'm still going to get a good body of flavor, which I absolutely love. So ristretto for me, it kind of has that Italian feel as well. I want to get this authentic. And like I said, I generally was about to go to Italy before the lockdown came through. I had my tickets booked and everything. We were off on to World Champs, and then the chaos ensued. But luckily, we've got this beautiful flavor sensation.
I'm so sorry that you couldn't. So this is for you, just to ignite that fire and that love for Italy that you didn't get to experience last year.
Yes.
And
now,
to get into it.
Jamie, the Ispirazione Napoli's dark and intense roast gives a velvety and somewhat of a creamy cup with an extremely thick body and a kiss of pleasant bitterness. And definitely getting it in that aftertaste. It's intense. It's a lot of flavor, but at the same time, when you have it in a ristretto like this, it's a perfect combination. I mean, that balance of the body, the acidity, it's got this velvety feel to it as well. And just on the end, I'm even getting a touch of cream. I mean, come on.
Living for it.
This is Italy for me.
You'll see in Italy, like, there's so many coffee shops around, so everyone's always sitting, you know, in the middle of the day, just having a little bit of coffee,
and they're just loving it. Are they just jazzing with their coffee on? Hey, 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 hey. No?
Definitely not like that, but obviously I went for the espresso, and so now I'm going to get to explore and just reunite a bit of nostalgia for me this morning. So cheers to you. And now maybe you can move it. Cheers, okay, let me get into it.